Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondence Club of Japan. Thank you for coming this evening. I have the pleasure to welcome our guest speaker today, Mr. Torosaki Katayama. He's a co-leader of Japan's Innovation Party. Now we have elections in the 22nd of October, and all parties are gearing up to get more seats. And our guest speaker today is one of the speakers in a series. We invited all party leaders to come and speak here on an equal basis, and we hope all come, including Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. And we are not going to make any political speeches, just introduction of our guest. And Mr. Katayama was born in Okayama Prefecture, and he graduated from Tokyo University. And he started his career at the Agency of House Affairs in 1958. And then he became Okayama Vice Governor, and then he was elected to the House of Councillors representing LDP, and then that was in 1989, and then he moved to other parties and was one of those who established the Japan Innovation Party. I think it was in Osaka. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our guest speaker, who will talk about the politics, and then we'll have questions and answers. Thank you.
どうも皆さん、こんにちは。
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
今ご紹介があったと思いますが、私は日本維新の会の共同代表ということになったと思います。片山虎之助でございます。
As you just heard in the introduction, I am 虎之助Katayama. I am the co-leader of Japan Innovation Party.
この協会のこういう催しに呼んでいただきまして大変ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
聞いたんですが、私が第一号らしくて、いかにも日本維新の会がこういうのが真面目ですよね。すぐ皆さんにお答えできる。その上で大変第一号というのは光栄でございますので、どうかよろしくお願いします。
Thank you very much for inviting me to the event to be organized by the FCCJ Japan. As I understand, we are the first of other political parties to be invited on this occasion or on in the run-up to the election at the FCCJ. We take these invitations quite seriously and respond to whatever requests. So once again, I'm very much honored to be invited here.
私の経歴を簡単に申し上げますと、私は大学を出て自治省というところにおりまして、平成元年の消費税選挙で参議院議員に当選させてもらいましてね、これで5期でずっと自民党だったんです。実は自民党で、まあ、ご記憶の方もあるやろうかと思いますが、定年制という問題がありましてね、私は高齢なもんですから、その定年制該当者でいろいろ議論があって、特例扱いにするとかしないとかということで。種垣総裁の頃にですね、そのまま残ると、まあ、揉めて簡単にいきませんので、立ち上がる日本というのがありましてね、今度引退しましたけど、平沼さん、与謝野さん、平沼さん、与謝野さんの声だと思うんですから、立ち上がる日本に帰りまして、石原さんが入ってきまして、石原慎太郎さんね、それでいろんな、これも事情があるんですが、大阪にできた日本維新の会と一緒なんです。それが平成24年でございましてね、それからまあこれまたいろんなことがあるんで言ってるの長くなるからやめますけれども、私は橋本さん松井さんの方に、残って分裂するときに維新の党ということなんです。それでまあ現在は共同代表とこういうことになっております。
So to give you a very brief history of where I have been, after graduating from a university, I went to work at the Ministry of Home Affairs, and in the 1989, when the consumption tax was the election issue, I ran for the House of Councillors election, and since then I have served 5 terms at the House of Councillors, and I have been with the LDP. I don't know if you know about this, but there's the retirement requirement based on the age. at the LDP, and so there was some discussion, as and since I am quite old already, there was some discussion around whether to allow for exception or not, but I simply wanted to avoid a complicated and messy debate, so I left the party. This was back when Mr. Tanigaki was the head of the LDP. So I left the party, and I joined the party Tachiagare Nippon, which was founded by a politicians like Mr. Hiranuma, who recently retired, and Mr. Yosano. And then later, Mr. Shintaro Ishihara joined that party. So I was part of that party. And then after that, there were some events took turns. And in the end, we came to join the party that was set up newly by the new initiatives of Osaka. And that was back in Heisei 24, 5 years ago, so that 2012. And then I have come to work with Mr. Matsui, who is the current president or the head of the Japan Innovation Party.
はい、それで座って後話させていただきますが、この選挙における我が党の政策というお話だったような気がしますので、ざっとしたことをお話をさせていただきたいというふうに思います。 今回、衆議院が前の解散になってから約3年ですから、2年10ヶ月を超えましたんで、解散があって当然なんですが、じゃあ唐突な感じがありますね。だから7条解散の是非だとか解散の大義だとか議論になっておりますが、そういう話はもういたしません。それでこの解散の結果で、民進党中野党第一党がなくなりましてね、簡単に言うと、 例の小池さんの希望の党と枝野さんの立憲民主党中ですが、そういうことになって政界参事じゃなくて野党参編がね行われたように格好になっておりますが、我が党と希望の党はかなり立ち位置や政策に似ておりますけれども、我が党はもう今まで通りの考え方で一貫して進むと、こういうことでございます。
Let me talk a little bit about the policy. Allow me to sit down. And I'd like to talk a little bit about the policies of the party. So it's been 2 years and 10 months since the diet was resolved last time. So we could expect to have the diet or the House of Representatives dissolved any time. But then I have the sense that it was rather called for out of the blue. Of course, there have been some debates about whether to allow for a resolution of the diet based on Article 7 of the Constitution or how that should be limited. There is also criticism that this dissolvement of the parliament of the diet was without any cause. But I don't intend to go into the detail of whether it was right to dissolve the House of Representatives or not. As a result of this dissolution, partly because of that, the biggest opposition party, then the Democratic Party of Japan, is now gone. And now there's the Party of Hope, which was set up by Governor Koike, and the Party of the Constitutional Democratic Party of Japan that was founded by Mr. Edano. So rather than leading to political reforms in general, it seems like there was a shakeup among the opposition parties. At any rate, the thinking of the Party of Hope and our party, the Japan Innovation Party, are quite similar, but we believe that we will always be consistent with our own party policies at the Japan Innovation Party.
野党再編の結果、与党と我々、保守の立場でありながら、中道中ですかね。 しかも保守でも改革する人たちをしている私どもの所と、希望の党と、リベラルというんでしょうか、その左と三極対決の構図になって分かりやすいと、こういう議論があります。したがって先ほども言いましたが、立ち位置や政策は小池さんのところと似てるもんですから、希望の党とは東京と大阪の小選挙区でお互い連携しようと。 お互い立てないと、簡単に言うと、東京にはこちらが立てない、大阪には希望の党が立てないと、こういう連携をいたしました。
So as a result of the reshuffling of the opposition parties, the structure seems to have become more clearly understood. In other words, there's the ruling party on the one hand, and then there are opposition parties, and there are three main parties within the opposition. One is the conservative, but rather middle ground and reformist-minded party, which is the Japan Innovation Party, and also the Party of Hope. And then there's the liberal or the left-wing type of party. So it really is a fight amongst the three major parties. So it's the structure is more easily understood. And as for our own party and the Party of Hope, Ms. Koike's party, the position and the policies are somewhat similar. So we will coordinate in Tokyo and Osaka to the extent possible, or to put it more simply, we will not be fielding the party candidates to the other party's candidates. In other words, we will not field any candidates in Tokyo where there are the candidates that's fielded by the Party of Hope, and we will not be, or Party of Hope will not be fielding any candidates in Osaka where we already have the candidates fielded. So we will have coordination or cooperation for the small constituencies.
だからそれ以外では、きれいに言うとお互い切磋琢磨すると競争するとこういうことでございまして、今後これ以上連携が深まるかどうか、この選挙の結果や今後の動向を見ていくということになると思います。我々は立党5年の今まで実績というのかキャリアがありますが、小池さんとかできたばっかりですわね。なるほど、いろいろ似ておりますけれども、どこがどうかもう少し見させていただくと、こういうことになると思います。
So apart from these, we will really have to see to what extent we can cooperate. And we will have to look at the result of the election and the developments post-election as to what extent we can collaborate with each other. It's been 5 years since we founded our party, so we have track record, or we have career, as it were, as having been active as a political party. On the other hand, Ms. Koike's party has just been formed, so we will have to see where we are like-minded and where we aren't. We really have to discern the differences more closely going forward.
私どもの今回の選挙に臨む一番大きい政策は教育の無償化なんです。我々は相当前から言ってるんですが、今回の選挙ではほとんどの党が同じことを言っておりましてね、どこに専売特許があるわけじゃないんで、結構なことなんで、一種の流行ですわね。で、これをやろうということなんですが、ちょっと長くなりますが、我々は教育の無償化の財源を、教育の無償化の根拠を憲法に書くということと、財源をですね、消費税じゃなくて、消費税の質変更じゃなくて、身を切る改革、徹底した行財政改革、その他で財源を、主力の財源を出すと。これが他の党と違うところであります。
The biggest policy of the party is to make education free of charge. This is something we have been pushing for from a long time ago, but now almost all the parties are saying exactly the same thing. It's not like we have exclusive ownership of this policy, so that's quite fine. It seems like it's been quite trendy to be campaigning for this free education for free of charge. But when it comes to how we will realize this policy is different, we are saying that the source of funding for making education free of charge should come from painful reform and thoroughly implemented administrative reforms, rather than changing the purpose of the or the changing the use of the consumption tax.
これから次に大きい課題というのか、課題は憲法改正でございますが、我々は憲法改正賛成です。
And the next policy, major policy initiative, is the amendment of the Constitution. We are for the amendment of the Constitution. By the way, the making education free of charge, that should be stipulated in the Constitution.
憲法改正で我々が、我が党が選んだテーマは一つが今の教育無償化、 2つ目が地方自治、地方分権改革というんですかね、あるいはそれが中央は中央の統治機構改革ということね。それからもう一つが憲法裁判所の設置、法律の違憲性を審査してもらう、そういう特別の裁判所を作ると。今の最高裁やりたがりませんから、やりたがるところを作ろうと、こういうことです。
As for the specific themes of the amendment to the Constitution, we have chosen the following. First is what I just talked about, making education free of charge. The second is to have reform in terms of devolution of powers to the local governments. And the next one is the changes to the governance structure at the central government. And then another themeis to set up a constitutional court. This court will review if certain laws are constitutional or not. The Supreme Court is not willing to make any decision on the constitutionality of laws, so we will set up a specific organ for that.
9条改正については今までは考えてなかったんですが、今年の5月に、憲法記念日に安倍さんがああいう問題提起しましたんで、これには両論ありますけれども、真剣に検討して、党としての結論を出そうと、こういうことにしております。
As for the amendment of Article 9 of the Constitution, that is something we had not thought about in the past. However, on the Memorial Day in May this year, Prime Minister Abe raised this issue of the Article 9. There are two ways of thinking about it, and we will take this matter quite seriously and be engaged in in-depth discussion, and then we'd like to come to a conclusion as a political party.
日本の我が国の憲法の一番の問題は、憲法というのは明治憲法と今の憲法と2つあるんですが、一回も国民が参加してないということなんです。国民が一回も意思をしてないんです。まあ明治憲法は当時の明治の初めですから、21年ですか、判断制が完了 で、今回 の憲法はこれも議論がありますが、まあ、GHQ が案を作って、最終的には日本の議会が認めたんですけれども、じゃあ国民が参加してませんわね。で、これは大変憲法の正当性から問題がありますよね。それから国民に馴染みがないんですよ。だから憲法をまとっときゃいいという、そういう考えが割に横行するのは、そういうバックもあるんじゃないかと、これは私個人の意見です。
The biggest problem issue about the constitution in Japan is that there have been two constitutions in Japan, the Meiji constitution and the current constitution, but the biggest problem is that there was no participation by the citizens.And there was no occasion or opportunity for the people to express their will. As for the Meiji Constitution, that was made and sort of imposed by the Meiji era or Meiji Emperor. And the current constitution, in the case of the current constitution, the proposals were made by the GHQ, and it was approved by the Diet of Japan.But there was no involvement of the people, so there's no authenticity, or it hasn't been properly acknowledged by the people of Japan, and the Japanese people don't seem to be that much familiar with the constitution. I think there's a sense that as long as we have something, we have a constitution and we have that over us, then that should be fine. This is my own personal opinion, by the way.
安全保障体制についてだけ言いますけれども、現実に即した安全保障体制を構築すべきだと我々は考えておりまして、2年前ですか、安保法制、集団的自衛権を認めた法制については、我々はですね、反対しましたというのはちょっと広すぎると、日本近海の米韓防護などを中心にした自衛のための集団安全、限定的集団保障体制はやむを得ないと。しかし今の安倍さんの法制はちょっと広すぎると、こういう考えを持っておりますが、まあこれはまた別の議論でございまして、あとはタブーなき検討すべきではなかろうかと。例えば GDP1% 枠というものがいいのかどうか、あるいは敵基地攻撃能力を持つのがいいのか、あるいはもっと ミサイルの防護体制を強化すべきではなかろうか、そういうものは多分なき検討をこれからやっていく必要があるんじゃないかと、こういうふうに考えております。
As for the security issues, we believe that we should put up the systems for security that is based on reality or that is more realistic. 2 years ago, there was the security bill that was proposed, which would allow for collective right to defense. And back then, we were against that bill because we believed that the application or the scope of application was too broad. Of course, if it comes to defending the U.S. vessels in the oceans that are near Japan, and if it is for the purpose of self-defense, then we will have to allow for a collective right to defense. But what was being proposed by Mr. Abe seemed to be too broad in its application. And we believe that there are other issues that should be discussed without any sense of taboos. For instance, we should also discuss whether there should be a cap put on 1% of GDP in terms of the defense expenses, defense budget. We should also, there's also the issue of whether we should have the capabilities to attack the other military bases or military bases in other countries. And there's also the issue of strengthening the defense capabilities against the missiles.
私の方からの説明はこのくらいにさせていただいた後はご質問があればお答えできる範囲でお答えします。
So with that, I'd like to conclude my presentation, and I'll be happy to take questions.
Thank you very much for your questions. We would like to open the floor to your questions and answers. But first, I would like to ask how many members in the parliament currently, in the upper house and lower house, his party has, and what is his goal of in the elections?
Currently,
we have 15 in the lower house or House of Representatives and 12 in the upper house or the House of Councillors. But Mr. Yoshimi Watanabe recently left the party, so that makes it 11 now at the House of Councillors. So that makes a total of 26 Diet members.
So the 今の国会では衆議院は21人、参議院は11人以上いると単独で法案が出せるんです。法案の提出権が参議院はクリアしましたわね。去年12人に当選しました。10人になりましたから。衆議院は今15人ですが、最低21人になりたいというのが当面の目標です。
In the House of Representatives, you have to have 21 to be able to submit a bill independently, and that number for the upper house or the House of Councillors is 11. We have made that number for the House of Councillors. We had 12 that were elected that are our party members to the House of Representatives, so we have satisfied the requirement there. And as for the House of Representatives, we only have 15. So at the minimum, we'd like to increase the number of members to 21 at the House of Representatives so that we can submit bills independently. So that will be our goal for the time being.
はい、ゲイリポーター酒井優斗です。よろしくお願いします。率直にお伺いいたしますけれども、日本維新の会は同性婚またはフランスのパクスのような同性間のパートナーシップの実現に賛成ですか反対ですか。よろしくお願いします。
Okay, My name is Yuji Sakai from Gay Report. I have a question. Is your party for or against the same-sex marriage or something like Pax in France? So are you for it or against it?
私は答えるのか。同性婚
フランスの。
その問題はね、今世界的に大きい問題になって日本でもね、いろいろ出てきてますけれども、我が党は党として検討はしてないんです。 だから支給かどうか知れませんが、今選挙ですからね、選挙でも進みましたらきちっと検討したいと、こういうふうに思います。まあ、これ難しいわね。しかしかなり個人的に差があるわ。
That is a certainly a huge issue that is being debated across the countries in the world. And on that particular issue, we have never really looked into it or had discussion as a political party. For sure, and we have to face the upcoming election. So after the elections are over, we would like to delve into that issue. But I would say that it is quite a tricky or sensitive issue. And it seems like there are differences amongst the individuals as to how they think about this issue.
Thank you for giving the talk. My name is Patrick Walter with German newspaper Frankfurter Allgemeine. I have three short questions. When you talk about free education, what do you mean by that? Do you mean free for all? Free in high school, or do you mean free university studies maybe as well? And how do you want to finance that? Second question is, when you talk about devolution of power, can you go more into details? What do you mean by that? Do you mean maybe even giving tax authority to the prefectures? And third question, as you are collaborating with the Party of Hope, what is your impression? What do you think about that Koike-san is not going to run for the lower house? And what does it mean for the success of the Party of Hope and your party when you don't have a chairman leading the campaign?
まず最初、教育の無償化についてですけれども、具体的にこの無償化というのは何を指していらっしゃるのか、全員にとっての教育の無償化、それとも大学も含めて無償にするのかということなのか、そしてその財源的な手当はどのような仕事をお考えなんでしょうか、というのが最初の問題、最初の質問です。2つ目の質問は、地方分権改革ということをおっしゃいましたが、これも具体的にどのようなことを意味されているのか、例えば課税権を県に、都道府県に移譲するということをおっしゃっているんでしょうか。それから3点目の質問ですが、希望の党に関して、代表の小池さんが衆院選には出馬されないということを言っていらっしゃいますが、これは希望の党の成功については、維新の会の、成功についてどのような影響を与えると思われるでしょうか。党の代表ご自身が代表自身も選挙に出ないということはどのような意味を与えるんでしょうか。どのような影響を与えるんでしょうか。
はい、いろいろご質問いただきました。ありがとうございました。最初の無償化なんですが、これは幼児教育から、だから今でいうと保育所、幼稚園から大学院まで考えてます。それ、各種学校までどこまで入れるかなんですが、もうできるだけ広く考えております。ただいっぺんにやるんじゃありませんよ。段階的にやっていく、財源と見合いながら。それで我々の試算ではそれによって4兆3000億円お金がかかると試算ですが、この4兆3000億円を精査してみなきゃいけません。かかる計算では5兆を超える計算もありますしね、3兆ぐらいで済む計算もあるんです。だから無償化ってどこまで見るかですね。授業料やまあ教科書はただにするんでしょうけど、あといろんな付帯的なことをどこまで見るか、これも精査の用があると思いますね。今の大学は全流になるんですよ。もう高校卒業生がみんな入れる大学を選ばなければ。だからそういうので国民が納得するかどうかですね。だから大学の統廃合や学生の質の向上中と絡めないと。だから相当大きい問題ですから、時間をかけて段階的にやるということであります。だから財源は我々の試算では4兆3000億円だから、我々は言ってるのはまず国会議員、地方議員の数を減らすと歳費を削るということ、これは大したことありません。象徴的な意味で問題は地方公務員と国家公務員、この人件費が26、7兆なんですよ、単年度で。でこれを例えば 5% 削ればですね、かなり出てくるんで、しかもこれもそう簡単にいきません。 定員を補充しないようなことでやっていくんで、人事勧告制度がありますし、だからこれは知恵を出さなきゃいかんのですが、私どもが言っているのは、例えば地方の出先機関中なんだ、国の今国家公務員が30万人おるんですよ。30万人のうち地方におるのが20万人なんです。東京におるのが10万人なんで、約大雑把に言いまして、防衛庁なんか外しますよ、普通の公務員ですから。その20万人は全部いらないとは言わないけど、まあ半分にはできると私は思うんです。だからそういう今の国の地方出先機関がやってる仕事は、都道府県でできるものは都道府県に移して、どうしてもできないものは中央に引き上げて、地方出先機関なくしちゃう。行政事務やってるのは特殊のものは別ですよ、税金を取ったりなんかの。だからこういうね、大きな荒療治をやって教育無償化をやらないと、消費税を単に上げてそれを首都変更やるなんていうことは、私はなかなか国民の納得得られるのかなと、こういうふうに思ってるんで、これは少しロングランの議論をさせていただきたいと、こういうふうに思います。
Thank you for asking questions. The firstlet me answer the first question as regarding the free education. We'd like to include from the kindergarten age, in other words, all the way from kindergarten and nursery school to university and graduate schools as well. That's the scope that we are looking at. And whether we should include the so-called other types of schools or various other types of schools or not, that's something we have to think about further. We don't intend to have a reform all in one go. We will have to take step-by-step approach as we look at financial resources that will be available. According to our simulation, this would require, or free education would require 4.3 trillion yen, but we have to closely examine this figure as well. Some simulations indicate that we will need more than 5 trillion yen. Other types of simulation indicate that it would only be 3 trillion yen. So we have to closely examine this. And to what extent we can provide free education, we certainly, the tuition and textbooks will be free of charge, but how much more that will be associated with education will be provided for free, that's something we have to look into further. Currently, all the high school graduates can go on to study at the university if they don't become picky, or at least the number of high school graduates and the capacities of universities indicate that anyone can go if they if they're not picky. But whether that will be accepted by the people in general, that needs to be discussed. So we may have to look into consolidating universities, or looking at the students, how our students would do as they go on to study at university. And once again, this will require 4.3 trillion yen according to our simulation, and we will get this source by reducing the number of civil servants and their remuneration, the number of civil servants in the national government and the local governments. The amount to be reduced will not be that big of a deal. It would only be symbolic. Currently, there are 20. The national and local government employees' personal costs amount to 26 or 27 trillion yen per year. If we can reduce by, say, 5%, then that will produce a substantial amount of money that will be freed up. So I realize this is not easy, but we will try to make this realized by not replacing the public servants that retire, but then we have to also think of the current personal administration and the practice. So again, we realize this is not that easy. But then we believe we can have a substantial reform. Currently, there are 300,000 national government employees, and of these, 200,000 people are at the prefectural offices of the national government body, and there are 100,000 employees that are stationed or that are based in Tokyo, except for the specific ministries like defense ministry. So there are 200,000 national government employees that are sent over to the local government offices. I don't intend to say that we don't need all 200,000 of them, but at least we believe by implementing reform, we can have this number. So by eliminating the national governmental structures that are in the local governments, we can reduce the expenses, and by having a sweeping reform, we can generate more funding that can be used for making education free. What is currently talked about, which is to change the use of consumption tax and raising the consumption tax and changing the use of that, I think that's not easy, and that it's not easily accepted by the people.
それからの質問で中央文献の中身なんですがね、課税自主権というのはこれを大幅に拡大すると、今日本の制度ではほんのわずかな部分だけ課税自主権を認めているんです。大枠は全部国が法律で決めているんです。だからこれを大幅に認めるというのと、地域立法権ですね、法律と同じぐらいの力を持つ地方の今条例というんですけれども、これの権限を認めるというのがまあ中身ですよね。それから体制では道州制といいましてね、都道府県をなくしてもっとこの国と市町村の中間、基礎的自治体の市町村の中間のそれを大きくする道州制、まあ反対がありますけどね、これをどうやるかが中央文献改革で大きな中身だと思います。課税自主権、地域立法権、それから道州制の扱い、こういうことになると思います。それから小池さんの問題は本には出たいんでしょうねと私は思ってるんで分かりませんよ。で、代表が出ないというのは迫力がないんですよ。ただね、あれだけ大騒ぎをして都民が期待して知事になって、それを1年やそこらでやめるっていうことが通るか通らないかですよ。だからトータルで彼女はどっちがいいかということを考えてると思いますが、その結果がまあ明日の5時まで立候補できますからね、5時まで待たないと分かりませんわ、偏見時代だから。
As for your second question about the devolution of power to local governments, what is meant by that is to expand the authority of the local governments to be able to levy taxes. According to the current system, there's only a small portion of authority that local governments have in levying tax, and most of it is decided by the national government. But we'd like to expand the portion or expand the part that can belevied by the local government. And also we'd like to give the local governments governments the power to enact something that is on an equal footing as a law. Currently what the local governments enact or would put in place is an ordinance, but this should be strengthened to something that is similar to law.And we also want to change the structure of the local government. And we'd like to abolish the current prefectural system and have a wider-based state-like government. So there's the central government and the local municipalities at the moment. So we'd like to set up something that is bigger than the prefecture, that would encompass several prefectures, and that would be more, that would be a bigger unit of local administration. We are aware that there's opposition to this idea, so this is another major a point as to how we can implement this or make this happen. And so once again, to summarize, what we mean by devolution of power to local authority, local governments, is to give the power to levy taxes to the local governments, give power to enact something like law to the local governments, and to introduce something, something that would abolish the current prefectural system, but instead would incorporate something that would be bigger than prefectural government. And as for the third question regarding Ms. Koike, I would presume that she truly wants to run herself. If the head of the party doesn't run for the election, then that's not taken seriously, or that doesn't wield a lot of influence or force. But she was elected the governor after many turns of events, and was very much supported by the citizens of Tokyo. So if she were to quit that job within a year or so, I'm not sure if that is accepted or not. So that's something that she will have to think about if she wishes to run for the election, that filing or notification will be accepted till 5 o'clock of the day of the notification of the election. So I guess we will have to wait until 5 o'clock that day. It can change a lot, or she seems to be capable of making broad changes or sudden changes. So we'll have to wait and see.
Yes, please.
Martin Kölling with the German Financial Daily Handelsblatt. Maybe two short questions. One is regarding your cooperation, possible cooperation with the Jiminto. Are you willing to enter a coalition government if numbers show it's necessary, and under what conditions? Secondly, looking at the realignment, the political realignment of Japan, of the political landscape in Japan, do you think that this political realignment is necessary or is a good development for Japan, so that the split of the Democratic Party might be in a longer term good for political hygiene here, so that there's a more clear center-left party, a more clear other choices on the conservative spectrum?
ドイツの2つ短い質問があります。1つ目が、自民党との協力の関係の可能性について、例えば数の上で必要であるということであれば、そして向こうからそのような申し出があれば連立政権に参加するご意向をお持ちでしょうか、またもしそうなのがそうであるならば、どのような条件で連立政権に参加されるのでしょうかというのが1つ目。2つ目、政界の再編に関してですが、これは長期的に見て日本にとって良いことなんでしょうか。より具体的には、日本、民進党が分裂したというのは、これは、中道左派が誰なのかということを明確にするというような観点からも、長期的に日本の政界を健全にするという意味で良いことだと見てらっしゃいます。
大変難しい質問なんですが、自民党と連立することは考えてません。ただ今もですね、政策は我々は是々非々ですから、いいことは自民党とも十分組みますしね、自民党と意見が合わないとか反対してます。ただまあどっちかというと、ぜぜひぐらいですね、今は。ぜぜひじゃなくて、ぜぜぜひぐらい。だけど一緒になる、連立を政権を組むということは考えておりませんが、ぜぜひの体制は今後とも続けていきます。例えば憲法なんかでは、中身によりますけれども、自民党組んでいきましてね。だから安保法制の時には、修正協議やったんですが、破綻したんですよ、私も出て。自民、公明とかなり議論して、いいとこまで行ったんですがね、彼らは法律を直すのは勘弁してくれということなもんですから、我々は法律を直さないならもう嫌だと、付帯決議は他のことで約束するのは嫌だということで、決裂しましてね、反対に回りましたけれども、基本的には是々非々の路線でいきますが、今の国会はね、本当に不毛の対立やってるんですよ。与党がもう押せ押せで数が多いもんだからね、で野党はまあパフォーマンスとね、審議拒否と、まあ、これも困ったもんですよね。だからきちっとね、合意形成する癖をつけないとね、バカンされますよね。それが一つですね。それから、
So, thank you for your questions. They are rather difficult to answer. But as for the question of whether we will form a coalition government with the Jiminto or the LDP, we do not intend to be part of that. However, when it comes to specific policies, we will decide on whether that policy is good or bad. So even if it is something proposed by the LDP, if it's a good policy, then we would agree with that. But if we don't agree, then we will oppose. So we will be fair and impartial, and we'll make a decision on policy by policy basis. At the moment, the ratio of agreeing with the LDP is more like 3-1 rather than half and half. But at any rate, we don't intend to form a coalition government with the LDP. We will make a policy by policy decision whether to cooperate with the proposals made by LDP. And so when it comes to the constitution, it depends on the content or proposed content of the amendment to the constitution, but it's likely, or we could potentially cooperate with the LDP on constitution related issues. As for the security bill, we tried to negotiate an amendment to the then proposed security bill. I participated in that discussion. We had in-depth discussion with the LDP and Komeito Party, and we thought perhaps we could broker an agreement, but in the end, it didn't work out. We proposed that the security bill be amended, but LDP and Komeito Party refused to change the text of the security bill, and so they were not willing to accept having like a supplementary resolution attached. So in the end, we ended up opposing that security bill. So once again, we will make a decision on a specific policy by policy basis. Having said that, I would have to say that the current national diet is not productive at all. The the ruling party is bulldozing through the bill with just because they have they completely outnumber the opposition. But the opposition parties, on the other hand, are always thinking of just putting up a performance for the sake of performance, or they refuse to deliberate on the bill. So we have to correct this approach or attitude, I believe.
民進党がなくなったのはいいことだと思いますよ。あの党はね、いい人も大勢おるんですけどね、物が決まらないぞと、ことがあると遠心力が働くんですよ、求心力じゃなくて、だから物が決まりませんわね、だから今の票がずっと分かりやすくなってるのと、これは私個人の意見ですけど、日本の二大政党はね、自民と民進じゃないんですよ、どっちかと自民と我々なんですよ、基本的な、ね、価値観や国家観が一緒で。大きい政策は一緒で、安全保障や経済政策は、ただその例えば中央分権だとか社会保障だとか成長戦略だとか、そういうのはかなり違うという方がね、二大政党で政権交代する方がずっとリアリティがあるんですよ。自民党と、ね、民進党の、ね、政権交代で二大政党はね、リアリティがない、イメージできませんわ。そういう意味では私は今の方が前進だと思いますよ。これは個人の意見ですから。だから今後どうなっていくかですよ、この3局が、例えば私どものところや小池さんのところが、これが今後の大きい課題だと思います。じゃあ我々は今3局だけども、そのうち2局になって自民党とそれこそ政権を争えればいいなっていうことを中では言ってるんです。中ではまた外に言って笑われますからね。
As for the second part of your question, I think it was good that the Democratic Party is now gone. Of course, there are good people that were part of the Democratic Party, but that party had this perpetual problem of not being able to make any decision. When something is at issue, rather than the centripetal force coming into work, a centrifugal force seems to be at play, and they are simply unable to make any decisions. So the current setup or current situation is a lot easier to understand. This is my own personal opinion, but if you think of the potential two major party system in Japan, it's not LDP versus Democratic Party, it really is LDP and us. When it comes to different values and the major policy issues on the security or economics, we share many things in common, and we are different when it comes to the devolution of authority to local governments or social security or growth strategy. So it's more realistic to have change in administration among these two parties. The change of administration between LDP and the Democratic Party, that's not realistic, or at least I certainly cannot imagine how that would take place. So I think personally, this is a step forward. Currently there is a fight amongst three political parties, ourselves and Koike-san's party and LDP. So that's the major issue. But internally, we are saying that rather than having a fight amongst three parties, it should be a fight amongst two parties, LDP and ourselves. Of course, we say this just internally amongst ourselves. If you are to say something like that externally, then we are afraid that we may be laughed at.
ケン・ジョセフ・ゲイツトーン、先週、亀静香がですね、泣きながら僕には相棒が見つかりませんと言って、去っていったんですけど、一つ目はですね、特に80、90以上の方から見て、単なる体制翼賛会のよみがえりっていうこと声が、とても多くなっています。それに対してどう思いますか。二つ目は安保についてですね、小池さんが、憲法と安保どっちも、応じないと入れませんと言ってますので、安保の部分どう思いますかということと、最後は憲法は修正ですか改正ですか、その2つです。
So, my question is, last week Mr. Shizuka Kamei left the political scene saying that he cannot find a partner to work with. So from perspectives of those in their 80s or 90s, it seems like there's a view that the current situation is very much like the pre-war situation of everybody just ganging being part of the same force. So what is your view on the current situation and how that compares to the pre-war situation? And second question is, Ms. Koike is saying that unless you agree with her policies on the Constitution and the Security Bill, then she will not welcome you in. So what is your stance regarding the security? And the last question is, are you proposing an amendment to the Constitution, are you proposing a modification of the Constitution or a complete amendment to the Constitution?
またなかなか難しい質問なんですが、体制翼賛会にはならないと思いますよ。時代が違いますわね。みんなこれだけ価値観や世界観が大きく違う中で一色になることはありませんしね。自民党だってあれは、政党の集合体みたいな性格がありますからね。私はそれは体制さんどういうことでどうやれてるのか分かりませんが、そういうことにはならないだろうと思います。それから小池さんが安保と憲法を一緒にしてね、踏み絵をやったっていうのは私もよく分からないんですがね。で、小池さんに近くないと、それ基本政策だと小池さんは思ってるんでしょう、おそらく憲法に対する姿勢と安保に対する姿勢が。だからそれが彼女の眼鏡にかなうようになれなきゃいかんということなんで、まあしかし討議して決めてないからね、彼女一人の権の可能性が非常に強いんで、よく分かりません。だけどまあ小池さんにとっては憲法と安保がですね、おそらく政治信条の基本だとこう思っておるから、それを少なくとも自分と同意でないとということだったんじゃないかと思います。それから最後の改正か修正かということなんですがね、今もうみんな憲法改正をしようという人もですね、今の憲法のあれ誰が作ったかどうなったかともう置いといて、今の憲法の3つの原則はみんな賛成してるんですよ。国民主権、基本的人権の尊重、平和主義や。だからね、そういう意味では精神から言うとね、それは基本的なことを直すんじゃないんですね。どっちかというとプラスするような加減中とまた公明党になりますからね。そういう意味で我々もその基本的な憲法の性格を変えるということを言ってるわけじゃないんで、当面の国民が切実に思うテーマについてね、憲法の中に入れたらどうかと、憲法をもっと国民に近づけたらどうかと、こういうのが我が党はそういう姿勢です。
As for your first question of whether we are getting, we are becoming more like a pre-war political status of having this imperial rule assistance association, I don't think that will be the case because the current times are different from the pre-war times. We have different values. We will not be all dominated by one single political thought. Actually, LDP is more like a collection of different political parties, I think. So I don't think we will become like a pre-war imperial rule assistance association. As for why Ms. Koike is demanding that one agrees with her on the constitution and the security, I don't quite understand why she is thinking that way. It seems like she believes she seems to believe that your attitude or stance on the constitution and the security are the very basic of your political belief. But then again, this is something that was only decided by herself. It seems there was no debate or a discussion. So once again, I'm not sure why she's requiring that you agree with her on these two issues. Presumably, she thinks that this should be the foundation of your political belief, and she wants people to that have the same views, political views, as she does. As for the third question of whether we intend to propose a complete change of the constitution or just a modification, we don't intend to change the basic tenets of the current constitution. In other words, the three fundamental principles of the constitution of national sovereign, people having the sovereign power, the respect of the fundamental human rights, and pacifism. Everybody is in agreement with these three principles. We don't intend to change the spirits of the constitution. So once again, we have no intention of changing these basics of the constitution. What we are proposing is to add more elements to the constitution, add something that people seem more familiar, that are familiar issues for the people to the constitution. So we don't intend to change the basic nature of the constitution. So we want to add new elements to the constitution, which is something the Komeito Party is saying, but we are a bit different from what they're saying as well. So we are proposing, once again, that we should incorporate elements that are more close to people to. So we will change the constitution so that it will be closer to the people in Japan.
Thank you. Please, short question. One question only.
フランス天皇及川と申します。端的にお伺いします。女性天皇や女性宮家の創設については日本維新の会はどのような考えをお持ちでしょうか。
My name is Oika from France 10. My question is your view on the having female emperor or empress and whether to have a imperial, your view on having a female head of imperial household.
あのね、これは女性天皇と女性宮家違うんですよ。それは。ただね、党としては決めてません。ただ我々はですね、天皇のああいう形の対応を各党みんな集まって決めましたわね。で、あとの女性宮家の問題は特に急いで決めるべきだということを私もあの会議で言っておいたんです。もうどんどんどんどん減りますからね、ご承知のように。今度また減りますし。ただ女性天皇はこれは大問題なんです。私は女性宮家っていうのはどういう形であれね、やっぱり作っておかないといかんのじゃないかという気がしておりますが、党として決めたわけではございませんので、もう少し時間をいただきたいと思います。
These two matters are completely different issues, whether to have a female emperor and to have a female head of imperial household. These are two very different things. And we have not made any decisions or policies as a political party. When it comes to the emperor, all the political parties got together and had discussion. And regarding the female head of house, imperial household, I was there when there was discussion, and I had the feeling, I have the feeling that this should be pushed forward, because if you didn't do anything about it, then the number of female imperial household members is declining, and there will be even fewer female members of the imperial family. That is expected very soon. So, but when it comes to female emperor, that is a huge issue. It's a very different issue. But I personally think that there should be a female head of imperial household. But then again, as a political party, we haven't made any policies about this, so we will need some more time on this issue.
Thank you very much for coming today, and I appreciate your insights. And I would like to give you 1 year honorary membership to our club. Please come again within a year and give us more insights about your policies. Thank you very much. All the best. Thank you for coming. Thank you, Kumano-san, for your interpretation today.
Thank you.